This week on Good Morning Monmouth, we talk Super Bowl commercials, gossip circulating the nation, videos that have gone viral, and give advice to students at Monmouth. Plus, we have a brand new Twitter game.
Stay tuned because this is your AM with A and M.
I live for the applause, applause, applause. I live for the applause, applause, live for the applause, applause, live for the way that you cheer and scream for me. The applause, applause, applause.
Monmouth. I'm Ashley Pacifico.
And I'm Michelle Rosenhaus. Welcome back to campus and GMM. This week we want to get right into our first discussion and go over our thoughts on our best ofs and worst of commercials for the Super Bowl. So Ashley, tell me what your least favorite one was.
Okay, I really can't lie to you. I really didn't like majority of the commercials. Thought they were not impressive at all. However, one that really stuck out to me was the Scarlett Johansson SodaStream commercial. I can't really describe it. Take a look and we'll discuss.
Like most actors, my real job is saving the world. Start with plain water, add bubbles, mix in the perfect flavor.
Yeah.
Look, a soda that's better for you and all of us. Less sugar, less bottles. If only I could make this message go viral.
You doing it, Scarlett. Yeah, you doing it. Changing the world, one sip at a time.
Sorry, Coke and Pepsi.
Oh yeah, she done it. SodaStream.
So, how did you feel about that commercial?
Because I don't know why that one was your least favorite. I thought there were a lot more bad commercials.
Really?
I really liked it, just because I love Scarlett Johansson. Though.
Okay, well here's my opinion on it. It was my least favorite because I thought it was so cheesy. Like, Scarlett Johansson is such a beautiful, established actress. She's not some, like, no-namer trying to, like, get some, like, 5 seconds of fame. She's a very established actress, you know, in brilliant pieces of work.
Right.
You really had to stoop down to, like, over-sexualizing yourself in a, like,
but she's
cheesy
seen as
way.
A sex figure. I just thought the cheese was, it was, like, the perfect amount for me.
Really?
Yeah, I really liked her.
Oh.
All right, well, my least favorite commercial for this one, I actually didn't like either of this company's. It was GoDaddy's commercial with the woman who quit her job. So check it out.
Let's talk about dreams and the people who choose to pursue them. Like Gwen, a machine engineer from New York. She's a real person with a real dream of starting her very own business. And she's got a message for her boss, Ted, who's watching the game right now.
Hi, Ted. I quit.
She just quit her job.
Yep.
In front of 100 million people.
Ciao, baby.
Build your dream online at GoDaddy. It's go time.
What did you think?
You know what? Okay. I thought it was tacky. There's been other things, viral videos on the web. I'm pretty sure we've even shown a few of people quitting their jobs and some, you know, crazy YouTube videos in different ways. I just thought, not that it wasn't an original idea, but it just still seemed fake.
What I didn't like about it was that they kind of overemphasized her quitting, but she's been on talk shows. She's gotten famous from this from the day after. She's talked about and promoted her new company with puppets, which I think is strange enough. But I don't like how she's getting this fame, and she said she didn't even dislike her job. And
like,
I thought the way she
her?
Quit, like, why wouldn't you pick someone who was very enthusiastic about hating their job?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not about this woman and her situation.
Me either. All right, so now that we've gone over our least favorite, what is your most favorite?
Oh, my goodness. So I really can't even tell you the purpose of this commercial because it melts my heart, and you'll see the stars of the commercial just kill me. So watch it because I'm going to cry.
Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go.
Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go.
All right, so I'm done crying, wiped away the tears. So I was just told that this was a Budweiser commercial. No, I'm kidding. I knew that. The Budweiser commercial with the Clydesdale and the puppy, passengers let her go is the background. It just, it hit me kind of like one of those sad, like the arms of the angel, like pet worse. Shelter commercials.
Because there's a horse and a dog.
A horse and a dog, and it ends happily, you know? So I was
and
really...
it's like a love story.
Yeah, I was really distracted by, like, if you went, make a long story short, if you went to my Pinterest boards, like, all it is like, animals, like, yeah. Puppies, pets.
It's a lot of puppies.
Tigers that I want to snuggle. So that number one was my favorite because a lot of animals were involved.
Yeah. Cute, I really like
cute little fuzzies.
Too. All right, well, my favorite was kind of on the opposite end of the spectrum.
Okay.
I went with the comedy route. Mm. Check out this Doritos commercial.
Hey, Mr. Smith, want to try out my time machine? It runs on Doritos.
Sure. So now what?
Gotta put the whole bag in.
Okay.
Yes.
It's really working, Jimmy! This is the greatest moment of my life!
Get it! My yard!
Jimmy? You're so old. It's the future!
This commercial just makes me laugh every time. I think I've watched it 10 times since then, just on YouTube alone. I think it's so funny that this man just, he gives him a hug like, wow, it worked!
It's brilliant.
Yeah.
You know, kids are so smart these days, and like, you know, that was always like the, I don't know, like in movies, yeah. Like Home Alone, mm-hmm. Kid outsmarts everyone. Like,
yeah.
Huge hit, huge comedy, so funny, so glad that they went back to, you know, an idea like that.
Yeah, I agree. I just think that the whole concept of it is awesome, and I look forward to the Doritos commercials every year mm-hmm. for the Super Bowl. I think they're the best ones, mm-hmm. so that's pretty much my favorite.
I agree.
Yeah.
I loved every second of it.
Me too. All right, well, we will be right back with more GMM to come. Stay tuned.
It's Timothy Green's first day at school.
What's in there?
He's about to fall
anything
over.
Anything he might need. There's a box of tissues on the bottom. It's a Band-Aids. There's a whole first aid kit, actually.
Mom, I can handle it from here.
You don't have to be perfect.
Have a great day.
That's too much pressure.
Have the day you have.
To be a perfect parent.
There are two people in the world who want you more than anything. They'll make some mistakes, but they will love you more than you can ever imagine.
There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
My life is full of statistics. Thing is, I could have dropped out of school and become one myself, but I didn't because I had people that believed in me. Here's another statistic. 7,000 students drop out every school day. That's one every 26 seconds. It's time that students know that we believe in them.
Inspire a student and share your message of support at boostup.org.
The first day stepping on the court, I couldn't keep up. That motivated me to step up my game. When I reach a goal, I set a new one the next day. And my next goal is to go to college. Mastering the court takes persistence. So does getting into college. I've got what it takes. So do you.
The true definition of hero and being a hero took a heroic effort.
Every day we bring to our fans the world of sports. We speak of heroes and heroism, but there are days when sports matter little. And heroes matter more. These heroes don't hit walk-off homers or buzzer-beating threes. They simply made a plan for what to do when disaster strikes. You never know when you might need to be the hero, because you never know if today is the day before a natural disaster. Prepare, plan, be a hero. Visit ready.gov.
Welcome back to Good Morning Monmouth. Our first segment back from break is our AM Roast, where we give you all of the surprises and gossip going on in the entertainment world. So our first topic is, it's Jonas Brother related. Kevin Jonas' wife,
your favorite,
she's all right, Danielle, gave birth to the first Jonas baby, Alina Rose, baby Alina Rose. And my husband in my head, Nick Jonas, just is like so elated. I've been keeping up with Instagram and Twitter.
What have they been saying?
So, okay, I'm gonna give you a little story, of course. Make a long story short, Kevin, Nick, and Joe, their grandfather, who like they idolize, just passed away like within the past like 2 weeks, and he was like the family hero and whatnot, and his memorial was the day before the baby was born.
Wow.
So Nick had tweeted something, it's not verbatim, but to wrap things up, it was kind of like, as one beautiful life ends, you know, another one begins. So excited to meet my beautiful niece. And I was sitting there just like trying not to weep, because he's perfect. And the baby is so cute.
I'm very happy for you and the Jonases.
Thank you so much, Michelle.
I feel like you're a part of them. So
I do too, thank you.
Yes. All right, so our next topic is there is a new possible Disney princess. This one is a high school student started a petition actually for kind of an oversized plus size Disney princess.
Okay.
Because she feels that that represents more. It'll give more girls that confidence that they need. And she already got 11,000 signatures on
it.
She only needs 4,000 more for her goal. So this is something that's going to be really big, I think, for Disney.
Absolutely. You know, like, all the Disney princesses, they are very diverse from one another.
Right. And but they all kind of have that same look.
They do. And that is a key factor, you know, that they are all missing. They're all, you know, typically this thin, drawn to be, you know, perfect little beings. And, I mean,
Real girls
have imperfections.
Exactly. And it's something that I think a lot of girls can take from and a lot of girls can learn from and get their confidence, because they don't need that glass slipper or that perfect dress, you know?
I'm like that.
Me too.
Okay.
But it's all right.
But it's okay. It's fine. So our third story is kind of crazy. For the Harry Potter fans, I'm sure you've all been going nuts. J.K. Rowling just opened up and said that she regrets a huge plot in her books. She regrets hooking up Ron and Hermione.
What?
I mean, that's like
what? Half of the plot.
That the whole time.
Right.
There's like
because
that tension.
Harry's not with like Ginny, I think her name is.
Right. And it's like,
yeah.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I've tried to follow along with all the Harry Potter movies. I've seen
the movies.
I've seen most of them, but you know, once they began like being like over 2 hours, I've really just lost touch. But however, apparently fans are like, Harry should have been with Luna, blah blah blah. Like that's the one thing. Like they're just going crazy talking about all different endings and things like that that they would have wanted. And I mean, do you think that was a smart decision for her to come out saying that she regrets doing that?
I think it's going to get her more of that talk started again about her. Maybe now that she's not in the spotlight all the time.
Yeah, but you think that's a little, it's like a spoiler alert now?
It is, but I mean now,
people are
going to say there's not going to be an alternate ending now.
Okay.
Who knows?
Very interesting.
Yeah. Our last topic for the entertainment news is Miley Cyrus, who is giving advice to Justin Bieber. And Justin Bieber has been in a little bit of a rough spot. I am not his biggest fan. We've known that from the previous shows.
Right.
I'm not a believer.
No believing.
So I want to quote it. So I'm going to read it, what Miley Cyrus said.
Okay.
You pay people to make sure you don't get in trouble and party at your house. Buy a house and add a club to it. I think that's great advice, because why not add a club to your house?
I mean, I
if
guess.
If you're that rich, like, if you bring the party to you. Don't drive.
I mean, that's so true. When you're to that, like, disgustingly famous level where you literally could afford whatever you want, like, and you're making these kind of stupid decisions, like, you could do it in the vicinity of your own home.
Right.
Not
get two homes. I know you have more than one home.
Duh.
Like, get a party home and get a cool, like, a relaxation home.
Yeah. You know, like, in a secluded area, lots of trees, no neighbors.
Yeah.
Gosh. Go with it, Biebs.
Biebs. All right, well, that's all the time we have left for your AM roast today. But now is our time for the newest segment we have, and that's our trending topics and guess that hashtag game on Twitter. So let's get started.
Yeah, this is where we dive into the online world, and that's smaller yet more interesting than our own. You know, you can't really connect to 4 million people on a daily basis in
right.
real life, but on Twitter, absolutely. So let's see what the Twitter world is talking about right now. First off, because we know that there was a huge event this past Saturday, Super Bowl. Bruno Mars's halftime performance has been, you know, getting tagged in almost everything.
Right.
Hashtag he's amazing, ex Michael Jackson, blah, blah, blah. So Bruno's is blowing up on Twitter.
I loved Bruno Mars' performance. I thought it was just amazing.
Yeah.
I think he's always so great.
Yeah.
But with this many people, like, of all ages and everything, I thought that he killed it.
Yeah, you know, typically I'm, like, not very interested in the game. I don't know if anyone's noticed, like, I'm not really big into the whole sports thing, not too athletic myself, a little coordinated. Anyways, so I'm really big on the halftime performances.
Right.
And sometimes they pick people that I really don't care about. And this time I was like, Bruno, come on, Bruno, kill it. He did.
I mean, my uncle has bashed every single Super Bowl performance for probably the past 3 years mm-hmm. that I've watched it with him, and he actually liked one of his songs. So
right.
That just proves that he's amazing.
You know, I'm not going to lie. Beyonce was great last year, but she also, like, blew out the stadium. So, like, that caused a little disruption.
A little bit of issue.
So, whatever. But Bruno killed it without being, like, oh, that was a big thing. Like, didn't even have to twerk, and it was amazing.
Yeah.
Like, they're talking about how he, like, brought back, like, old school class and, like, good performance. So, go, Bruno.
Yeah.
Tweet to Bruno Mars. Tell him how much you love him.
Our next trending topic was hashtag Sochi. There's only mm-hmm. a few days left until the opening ceremonies and those games. So tweeters are expressing their excitement
yeah.
as well as concerns over the homosexuality issues and Putin's problems with it. And I think that everyone is talking about it. It's only mm-hmm. going to get higher and higher in those trending polls for the weeks that it's going to happen. And it'll be interesting to see how the turnout is and what people begin to say as the game's gone and as they see what's been happening.
Yeah. It's really interesting, the Olympics.
I'm really excited for them. A lot of people are saying curling's going to be really cool. That's not my favorite game. I don't like curling. Do you?
Yeah.
I mean, it's like normal people, like your plumber could be on an Olympic team, which is kind of awesome. But.
Yeah, that is pretty neat. I don't really have, like I said, a specific sport that I'm like really eyeballing. But I do like to keep up. I like, like, go USA, you know, like, I'm a big, like,
you'll wear the shirt.
Yeah,
you know, like, go USA gloves.
How many gold medals do we have? Like, oh, my, we're doing great. Keep it up.
Let's go.
So, you know, when I can flip on the TV and put on the Olympics, I'm about it.
All right.
So, I'll tweet about it, probably. I'll complain about someone's outfit at some point or, the like, whether or not I like the footage and coverage of what's happening.
Yeah, a lot of people will complain about the social media coverage and stuff like that, so. That'll be interesting.
It will be.
All right, so our next topic is going to be the Guess That hashtag game.
Oh.
Now, Ashley, I am going to talk to you and read you some hashtags.
Okay.
And what's kind of been going on.
About what the celebrities are saying.
About what celebrities are saying.
So I took a little bit of a hiatus from Twitter, I'm not going to lie. I've been back and forth. You know, I've been very busy commuting in and out of the city. And sometimes I, you know, get on Twitter, but a lot of the times I'm sleeping. So Michelle is going to test my knowledge on what celebrities are tweeting about, essentially.
All right. There are going to be 3 questions in this round.
I'm really nervous.
First one.
Okay.
2 months, no cigs. Hashtag proud of myself. Is this A, Jennifer Aniston?
Okay.
B, Miley Cyrus?
Interesting.
Or C, Adele?
Well, congratulations to 2 months, no cigs.
Right.
That's great. Hashtag proud of you. Don't think it was an Adele because she has a baby. Jennifer
Aniston.
That'd
be an issue.
Two months
isn't enough.
I mean, I don't know. I just think Adele. Well, she probably does smoke. I don't know. I'm not judging. Jennifer Aniston is, like, beyond beautiful, so I don't want to picture her smoking. So I'm going to go with Miley Cyrus.
You would be correct.
Ooh.
It is Miley. Yeah.
What was
good
that?
For you. 2 months, no cigs.
Thank
Proud
you.
Proud of you, Miley.
Thank you.
All right, our next question.
Okay.
Cool. Paris, mm-hmm. .. Food, .. Awesome, .. Is it A, Zac Efron?
Okay.
B, Harry Styles?
Okay.
Or C, Adam Levine?
Okay, ooh, this makes me nervous because A, Zac Efron has a new movie coming out, so I feel like he could be traveling all over promoting the movie. Mm-hmm. B, Harry Styles, he's from, like, I think he's from, like, London, or, like, you know, he's One Direction is yeah. over, is, you know, not here. So I feel like he may be a fan of foreign foods to us.
Right.
And then Adam Levine, I don't know, he's been kind of off my radar.
I don't picture him eating.
At all, actually. So I'm going to go with Harry Styles.
You would be wrong. What? It is Adam Levine.
What?
I don't know what he's eating, what he's doing in Paris.
No wonder he's been
Maybe
off
he's
my radar.
With his he's superstar too, girlfriend.
He's too busy eating
She's
Parisian food. Okay, have a I'm croissant jealous. For me, please.
All right, and number three question. What a raging Friday night.
Oh, is it a Miley sandwich, again?
Made a sandwich, watched The Business of Being Born, hung out with a cat. Hashtag, I'm a grown woman, I can do whatever I want. That's all one word and one hashtag. The answers are A, Katy Perry.
Okay.
B, Lady Gaga.
Okay.
And C, Beyonce.
Wow, are you sure, like, Miley wasn't the answer? Because you know her song, it's like, it's my house, we can do what we want. No.
Right. I don't think she would be hanging out with a cat and making a sandwich.
You know, and I automatically thought it was Taylor Swift, too, because she's, like, a big fan of hanging out with her cat on a Friday night. I know that. I don't think Katy Perry is dating John Mayer, so like I feel like she'd be busy with that on Friday night.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm just saying.
She's got John, not the cat.
Right. And what was number two?
Number two was Lady Gaga.
And number three was
Beyonce.
Oh, Beyonce's busy with Blue Ivy and Jay-Z and like performing all over the world. I'm gonna go with Lady Gaga on this one.
It was Katy Perry.
Oh,
Katy,
man.
Catty, like cat, Katy Perry.
Gotcha. Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe John was there.
Maybe he was. Maybe she made him a sandwich. I can go that route.
Oh.
You know?
Interesting. I wonder what kind of sandwich it was.
I know. I wonder what she
did. She eat real people food?
I don't know. I think it was peanut butter. Definitely peanut butter.
Or Nutella. I don't know. Anyways, wow. I'm really kind of disappointed in myself.
All right. Next week, maybe you'll get a couple more.
I really hope so.
Yeah. All right, well, keep it tuned to Hawk TV 12 for some more Good Morning Mammoth in just a few.
Bring this meat.
Minutes of physical activity a day and eating well can help get your child healthy. So keep them active and eating well every day.
Skip a rope Saturday, freeze tag Friday, tap dance Thursday.
Home greens Wednesday, try a veggie Tuesday. Let's move Monday, split the sweet Sunday.
Eat well and move a lot.
Today is Saturday. Yeah. Today is Saturday.
All the healthy children, all the healthy children.
Get ideas. Get involved. Get going at letsmove.gov. That's letsmove.gov.
Over 13 million people are affected by famine, war, and drought in the Horn of Africa.
When you hear about suffering on this scale, you feel powerless.
But there's hope, because saving lives doesn't take a lot.
It just takes a lot of us.
Text a donation of $10, but do more than donate. Forward the facts to everyone you know.
Forward from our site.
Forward on Facebook.
And forward on Twitter.
We are the relief.
Well, Welcome back to Good Morning Monmouth. This next segment is AM Advice, where students ask for advice and we give our best possible answers. So our first question of the day is, me and my college boyfriend have been dating for 2 years now, and we both live in different states. We are about to graduate in May, and I'm so confused as to whether or not we should stay together after graduation. Oh my goodness, that's tough.
You gotta just go with what you think on that one.
Yeah.
I mean, after graduation, it's like you have different lives, but if you wanna make it work, you can make it work.
Here's my thing. Okay, if you're questioning whether or not you two should stay together after graduation, after 2 years, should you really be together?
That's a good point. Mm. But I mean, it's also a scary next step. Like, I feel like being together for 2 years in college is like not real life.
Like, yeah, like, I mean, here's the thing. Do you project having a future with this person?
Right, because college, it's like, are you really dating? It could go either way. Like, I've seen some relationships where they're like really serious, and I've seen some relationships where it's like, yeah, we're dating. It's like been 2 years.
Yeah, like it depends on the seriousness of the relationship and if you see yourself being with this person in the future. It also, if you like do want to do this, it's two other options. Long distance, or are you going to have the, well, are we moving somewhere together?
Yeah.
You guys need to have a serious conversation on like how you both feel about the relationship and where you stand in general.
Right. I agree. I think that's a good answer.
You're welcome.
Our next question. I love my roommate and we never have any problems except for his friend.
Okay.
I really don't get along with him and he always stays in our dorm for long periods of time. Should I say something to my roommate or just deal with it?
I'm sorry. If this is a room for two, third little like homeless friend needs to get out. Like, yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I happen to have felt this way before. And it's like, you just gotta say, get out or hang out when I'm not here or don't hang out. Like, he's awful.
You two are sharing.
Just be honest. If he's awful, he should know he's awful.
You two are sharing a 2x4. And if you're lucky, it's a 2x6. So to have a third person in there, sorry, you're taking up too much oxygen. You're gonna have to go.
Blunt.
Just so blunt. Be blunt about
it. You have to, because there's no other way that you can get around something like that. And it's an terrible situation to be in, but if you don't like someone, just tell them to leave. Like, that's your home.
But that's the thing. Like, if you're cool with your roommate, like,
yeah, that you said that you're best friends, like,
yeah, like, you're super close. Just be like, listen, is there any chance that, like, this, we can reclaim this room as,
go.
Like, ours?
Yeah.
And, like, kind of have him hang out elsewhere. Like, if there's, like, a common area, stick to that, like, way, you know, like, yeah.
No other way around it.
No. If I don't like someone, don't invade my room. Don't invade half my room. Just don't do it.
Just don't come near me, basically.
Oh, my goodness. I'm really mean. I'm sorry. But let's move on to the third and last question of today. So my roommate is joining a sorority, and I'm afraid that we're not going to be as good of friends because she'll want to hang out with her sorority sisters. What should I do to avoid this? Has this happened in your life at all?
It has.
It has.
Well, I wouldn't say she was like my best friend, but she was my roommate, and then I had this happen the next year where it was like one of my sweet mates.
Mm-hmm.
And it does change a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's no way to avoid her hanging out with her sisters and doing things, but you have to be like, hey, if you want to make this work, like, it's like a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You need to designate time with them and say, hey, why don't you hang out with your sisters another night and we can go out tonight? Or say, hey, can I join you?
Right.
Like, I've done that before where I've gone out with her and her sisters, or she's come and we've just had dinner together.
Just expect for, like, a lot of inside jokes that you know nothing about and they can't tell you.
It's going to be really awkward in the beginning, I feel like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I mean, one of my best friends now, she just studied abroad last semester and just moved into my apartment, like, this semester. She's in a sorority on campus, and they just had like the recruitment and bid week and stuff. So I've been hearing like a lot about like what's happening, and like it's an exciting time for them. So, you know, let show as much interest, you know, in
be supportive.
Yes, be supportive of like, you know, their sorority, fraternity, whatnot. But also, like, realize, be like, listen, like, can we do something this week? Or, like, you know, just you and I or whatever. It'll work out. It will. And be busy yourself.
Yeah, things have a way of working out with that. You just got to make the effort and make that point. So I think that's the only way.
Don't be sad. It'll work out.
Yeah. Well, this episode of Good Morning Monmouth is just about over. Thank you to everyone for keeping it here on Hawk TV 12 for our show.
We hope everyone has a safe and good week and avoids getting stuck in all this crazy snow. So once again, thank you for spending your AM with A&M. We'll see you next time.
I live for the applause, applause, applause. I live for the applause, applause, live for the applause, applause, live for the way that you cheer and scream for me. The applause, applause, applause.